Hi friends, in this video, I will explain how to build micro frontends using Angular. I will cover what micro frontends are, why they are useful, and how two micro frontends can talk to each other. I have built this application using two micro frontend apps. As you can see, these are two separate applications. When I click any of the buttons in the first app, the second app reacts to it accordingly. I will also explain how I created the host or cell application along with the two micro frontend applications and how I made them communicate with each other. It's not very difficult. This can be done quite easily. Alright, let me first explain what a micro frontend is. Micro frontends are a way of designing frontend web applications by breaking them into smaller, independent and self-contained modules or mini apps. Each micro frontend can be built, tested and deployed separately by different teams, and they can even use different technologies or frameworks. These individual frontends are then combined to create the full user interface of the application. Okay, why do we need to use micro frontends? As our applications grow in size and complexity, maintaining a monolithic frontend becomes increasingly difficult. Micro frontends offer a powerful solution to break down the complexity and scale your frontend architecture. So because of scalability, maintainability, faster development, technology diversity and code reusability, using micro frontends makes sense. Okay, when we talk about micro frontends, we also need to mention module federation. What is module federation? Module federation is a feature in Webpack 5 that lets different frontend apps or modules built and deployed separately share and load code dynamically while running. It's an important tool for creating micro frontends. Each remote app shares specific parts like components or services that the host app can use whenever needed without bundling everything upfront. Module federation helps create scalable micro frontend setups with faster releases and easier maintenance. Starting with Angular 13 and newer versions, using native module federation, mainly with libraries like Angular Architect's native federation, brings many advantages over older module federation setups that depended more on Webpack specific settings. So now I'll use native federation to build our micro frontend application. Let's get started. I have built this simple application using Angular 19. Right now, it's not a micro frontend app yet. In this app, there is a movies array and I'm looping through it to display each movies. When I click this button, it calls a function and I'm going to use this function later to communicate with the other micro frontend application. I'm running this application on port 4201. That's why we can see it working here. Alright, now let me show you the code for the other application. Think of this as another remote application that provides the number of tickets available based on the movie ID. Here you can see I have created a simple function to fetch ticket availability. For now the numbers are hard-coded. I am running this application on port 4202, which is why we can see it working here. This one is also not a micro frontend app yet. Alright, let's switch over to our host application. Here I have just added some basic layout code to show one application on the left and the other on the right. I am running this on the default port 4200, which is why we can see it displayed here. Okay, now it's time to start building the micro frontend approach. The first step is to install the native federation library in all three applications. Let me do that. Great, the installation is done. Next, we need to set up or initialize this native federation. For that, let me run this command. For the host application, let me give the project name and then the port is going to be 4200 and the type is going to be dynamic host. This command will create some files and update a few existing ones. Okay, let me run this command for the micro frontend applications. Let me give the respective project name and the port. The main difference here is that the type will be set to remote. If we look at the federation config files of the remote applications, we can see that the app component is exposed under the name component. Alright, let's see how we can load these exposed components inside our host app. In the host app, let me start by adding a template reference variable to these div elements. This way, we can use the reference to load each app inside its corresponding div element. In the app component, let me use viewchild to get references to these container elements. Like this. Next, let me create component references to hold the instances of the loaded components. To load the remote components, we can use the load remote module function provided by the native federation plugin. It's a good idea to move this logic into a service, so it can be reused easily across the application. Alright, let me go ahead and create a service for that. In this service, let me create an asynchronous function. Let me also pass the port and remote name as parameters. Inside the function, let me use a try-catch block. In the try block, let me return the load remote module function, which takes an object with the following properties. Exposed module, name of the module being exposed. Remote name, the name of the remote. Remote entry, the URL pointing to the remote's entry file. This should be based on the port. And an optional fallback. In the catch block, let me log an error using console.error and rethrow the error. Great, let's go back to the app component now. First, I'll create a constructor to inject the service we just made. Next, I will implement the onInit and onDestroy interfaces and add their corresponding lifecycle hooks. I'll mark the ngOnInit function as async since we'll be calling the async function from the service inside it. Inside ngOnInit, I'll add a try-catch block. In the try block, let me call the service's load remote component function, passing port 4201 and remote name movie list. We need to add await here, since the function returns a promise. And let me also assign this to a variable. Before creating the component inside the container, I'll clear the container first. Then I'll create the component using the create component function, passing in the exposed component name. This create component function will return a component reference. Let me assign that to this variable. And let me use this component reference to trigger change detection. Inside the catch block, let me have a console error statement. And in the ngOnDestroy, let me destroy the component reference. This is for cleanup purpose. Okay, we need to do one last step. We can see a federation manifest JSON. Here we need to mention the remote app name and the remote entry URLs. Let me do that for both the applications. That's it. Now let me start the applications. We can see our remote application is showing up, but the images are not loading, because this is a common issue when using module federation with Angular Micro Frontends, where remote apps try to load assets like images from the host base URL instead of their own, causing 404 errors or broken images. We can fix this by using absolute URLs or public URLs or by using CDN or by configuring base href in the remote application correctly. For now, let me change these URLs to absolute URLs. Great, this is working now. Let me also do the same to load the second micro frontend application. Okay, this looks good so far, but the communication between the micro frontends isn't set up yet. To set up communication, when the button is clicked in the first micro frontend, let me dispatch a custom event. Let me give the event a name, and in the detail property, let me send the movie's ID. In the second micro frontend, when the component loads, let me add an event listener to listen for that custom event. Then I'll retrieve the movie ID from the event's detail property. After that, I'll call the function to get ticket availability. Also, I'll use the ng-on-destroy hook to remove the event listener when the component is destroyed. That's all we have to do. Let me restart all the applications once. Now if we test, we can see our applications can communicate between each other. I hope you now understand how to create micro frontend applications using Angular. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. Also, please share it with your friends and colleagues. That's all for today. I'll be back soon with another interesting topic. Thank you. Bye.